Some historians dispute about the coming of Thomas to India. We will try to see today about the writings of some of the fathers of the church, also some important historians from the first centuries after Christ. First among them is Panthenus. He was a philosopher under the Alexandrian catechetical center. This center was opened by Dimitrios, the patriarch of Alexandria, who was reigning as 12th successor in the see of Saint Mark. In fact, soon after he became the patriarch, he established this catechetical center, which was open for learning about Christianity and Christ. It seems that a few Indians, delegates, went to meet him, asking his assistance to send a few learned people in order to dialogue with the Brahmins in India, also to teach the Indian Christians about the Christianity. Panthenus was selected for his apostolic zeal and his knowledge about Christianity. Panthenus reached India in AD 189 and 190. It seems that he saw the Indians are already using the Bible, the Gospel according to Saint Matthew. And he also had discussions with the Brahmins, and with his knowledge he helped the Indian Christians. These things are clearly written in his Acts as well as in the martyrology published later by the church, where the reference is very clearly made about Panthenus and his visit to India. The next one is Clement of Alexandria. Together with Eusebius and Origen, historians, they also state about the travel done by Panthenus to India and what he has seen in India, especially about the first Christian community. There is a beautiful text called Didascalia Apostolorum, the teachings of the apostles. Didascalia Apostolorum gives a clear picture of what the apostles have done in their activity, in their missioning. In this text, it is clearly mentioned that Thomas Apostle preached the gospel in India and he baptized. Of course, he also ordained priests. The next one is Saint Ephraim, lived from AD 300 to AD 78. He is one of the most beautiful fathers of the Church of the East, and he has written beautiful hymns. And in one of the hymns he writes, Thomas is the light who went to India to dispel the darkness. Through baptism, with the white robe, he dispelled the darkness. More than this, there is no evidence needed, in fact, to prove the apostolicity of Saint Thomas in India. The next one is Gregory Nazianzen, lived from 324 to 390. He was a bishop of Constantinople, where he explains about the apostles' activities. He mentions that Thomas did his apostolic ministry in India. Saint Ambrose of Milan, very famous bishop, he has also written about the apostolicity of Thomas in India. He speaks about the journey through the ship. He speaks about the Brahmins that he evangelized, and the various activities that he conducted in South India, especially about the port Musiris. Among the saints, Saint Jerome, who interpreted Bible, he mentions very clearly about the apostolic work of Saint Thomas in India. Gregory of Tours, he He lived in the 5th century and he mentions that there is a religious community in India as well as there are also churches in India. Isidore Sevin was a geographist who has mentioned that Apostle Thomas died in Kalamina. Kalamina is the name of that time for Mylapore. Saint Gaudensius of Brescia, he was a bishop of Brescia, he also mentions about the relics of Apostle Thomas and he mentions that Apostle Thomas died in India. So if we look at the span of the first to 6th century, there are at least 10 to 12 various church fathers clearly spoken about the apostolic work of Thomas in India. I would like to conclude stating that like Thomas, all the fathers of the church have written about the apostolic work of Thomas by the will of God. It is the providence of God that they have mentioned about the works of Apostle Thomas. So as we accept the apostolicity of St. Thomas in the Indian soil, we have to also accept the writings of the church fathers. Let us pray. Mighty God, it is your will and wish under your providence Apostle Thomas came to India and the church fathers wrote about him and about his mission. Give us the courage and strength to believe and understand deeply the mission the Apostle Thomas has done here in India, and give us the courage and strength to be apostles, missionaries like Apostle Thomas in India. Amen.